shining star of Kurapa University. Dr. Smitawan Jackie is the assistant professor of the Department of Chemical Engineering at Kurapa University. He is also the chairman of the three boards. The first one is the Institutional Research Board for Protection and Human Subject in the Research, or IRB. The second is Institutional Animal Care and Youth Committee, or IACUC. And the third is the Institutional Biosafety Committee, or IRB, at the Kurapa University. He received his PhD in the biochemistry from Mahidol University in the topic of gene expression and identification in Burkholderia pseudomallei. After finishing his PhD, he started as a lecturer at Department of Chemical Engineering, Faculty of Engineering, Kurapa University. As a postdoctoral fellow position in the Dr. Lichiden Laboratory at University of the New York. He studied the in vivo effect of radiation with the emphasis on identification cellular and the molecular biomarker of the exposure. Dr. Witwat Jaeyang is one of our plenary lecturers for the 6th Kurapa University International Conference. His lecture will be the past and the future perspective of research ethics. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Assistant Professor Dr. Witwat Jaeyang.
Respected chairperson of Kurapa University, the National Conference 2017, honorable participants, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, everyone. The movie that presented is like, I feel like everyone in the theater, I would like everyone to join me and listen with me, listen with your heart, not the thing that you have heard. Okay, 3 months ago, I was in Amazon with my friends, my little friends. Okay, one of them is Walata, she was here in Amazon. And I saw that one flowers, sunflowers, one of them was hurt by the others. I think that the other, they don't know that they were fixed by flowers, but I don't know you can think about it, because when you go into the forest, you can see the very high tree, and you can see that many lower tree was hurt by the higher trees. So this is the thing that I will encourage you to listen to my talk. The thing is that the first story that I would like to tell you is the story of Laika. Laika is she's female. She's the great dog that came from state of Moscow during a long time ago when US fighting with Soviet Union. You know that you're fighting to send the human animal into the space. And this Laika, she was kept from Singapore Moscow. She's a cute little dog. She's many people say that she's very nice. The first name of Laika is not Laika. Her name is Kuchevka, because Kuchevka is a Russian name. It means that it has the curly hair, curly fur. So when the first thing that Kuchevka on TV shows, she didn't smile, she's always bark, bark. So everyone say that, wow, it's Laika, because in Russia, Laika means barking. So Laika come on that TV shows. Okay. She's very nice, and scientists would like to make something good to her. She brought her, the scientists brought Laika's home and play with his kids and sleep together the night before Laika died. The first day, in November 3rd, 1957, Laika was walked into the capsule, petrified capsule. And at that time, she was very cold. She was very cold. And the Soviet Union reported that first 2-3 hours from that time, Laika was alive. The wetlessness didn't affect to Laika. And 6 to 7 hours, Laika died because of the heat and wetlessness. So after that, in 2002, there was leak of information from Moscow, because that Soviet Union was break to Russia. So the information leaked, and everyone knows that Laika was died within 1 to 2 hours. Laika was stressed, very stressed, within 1 hour. And that time, when you go to Russia, you can see the Laika Institute, the Laika Monument, Laika in the stem, Laika in books, everywhere is Laika. So people want to make the good thing to Laika. This is the first story. Let's see the second story. Anti-dandruff yet because of doctor treatment. He was sued by Mr. John. In 1966, doctor treatment made an experiment in the jail, in the prison. He treated something, lotion or everything, on the prison skin. And after that, 1996, Mr. John won. He won the suit. He got everything. He got, I think, $40,000 from three parts. The first, Dr. Crickman. The second one is the university that Dr. Crickman was. And the third part is Johnson & Johnson, which is the sponsor. So when you do the research, you have to think about the ethic because this thing. So when we talk about the kids, you know that when the social behavior science, they put children in here. The right hand side is the toxic chemical. The left hand side is their own toys. What do you think the kids will go which way? Toxic chemical or their own toy? They walk into the toxic chemical. That's the truth. So many researchers would like to test the chemical that they use in the household product for the kids to be safe. So they use the animal testing. So some company like Mark and Spencer, they strongly stated that they never use the animal testing. So you have to judge between two things, right? Use animal or not use animals. Okay, this is polio vaccine, saved millions of lives. Without vaccine, many lives will be threatened by polio, right? So it's animal experiment. And also, this is serum. When the snake bite, you need serum because they have the immune system to protect yourself. So you need to inject the serum you need to inject something from the snake into the horse, right, into the rabbit, and after that the horse and rabbit will create some immunoglobulin and you can take it. So you need animal because of your life. You need it. Okay, this is the vaccine. And also when you do the research with human, like this picture, to perform the research in the classroom research, you need to consider about you do something harm with your kids, with everyone that you send the information, or you is it a drug before you launch into the market? They have three phases. The first phase, you have to test it with the normal human with like 12 to 80 samples. After that, in the second phase, you need to use like a 100 into 400 of normal people to test that it's effective, no drug interaction. And after that, the third phase, you have to make it tested into the people that have that disease, like 1,000 people, something like that. They use humans, so you have to use the rabbit protocol. And also, today I would like to introduce you about the biosafety. Biosafety, when we use, like, this is an insulin type 2 diabetes, type 2, you need insulin. You know that. Only add-ons, you take the insulin from kid two times. You know, two times is very big. Two times and you get only 8 ounces. So, but now, they use CMO to produce insulin. Very easy, no? And this is a cell culture or everything. You know, this is the soybean. In 1996, soybean launched. And now until now, it's 2017, the crop of soybean crops, like almost 90% are GMO soybeans. So in the ethic in research, we have to think about the minimizing harm and maximizing benefit. I think you know this. And we use the many things to think, to learn about Nuremberg Code, Declaration of Helsinki, Beaumont Report, Sion, and Tokai. And in the animal ethic, we have 3 R's. Which are replacement, reduction, refinement, and biosafety. We categorize in 4 groups, like group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. Group 1, you can perform in the normal laboratory. Group 2, you have to make it in the special things. Yeah, they have details. 3 and 4, you cannot do it in Thailand. Okay, the good thing is that we would like to make a beautiful world. This is a summary of some ethical principles. I'd like to tell you about the integrity of some research. This is the story of this woman. She's the Japanese. Her career is very, very high career part because she knows how to make, you know, the embryonic stem cell. Embryonic stem cell is very special because you can make many cells. But this woman, Haruko, she invented one thing. She can invent it because the white blood cell of the mouse and change very easily to the embryonic stem cell is very, nobody knows before. She's very famous. And one day, I thought that one day, somebody will propose her name to get the Nobel Prize. But after that, she's famous. She got the higher promotion. And one day, scientists cannot do the experiment that she performed. They cannot do the experiment. And they form into the group. They ask that, why I cannot do that experiment? Because she has this method. One day, her colleague suicide. Her colleague suicide. Do you know Japanese culture? Yeah, it's very sensitive. When you do something not good and you feel guilty, they suicide. And after that, Margot comes and tell everyone that I'm sorry. The thing is that the woman that was suicide, she's the manager of the lab. And she do everything, I don't know, maybe it's contaminated with embryonic stem cell into the white blood cell or not. But I don't know, I'm sorry. She cried and sorry about that. Okay, this is the one thing with integrity, because after when they track back, they're very sloppy in the lab. They know the data collection. They don't have the good level. And we have everything just published. So we have to think about the ethical issues. Okay, this is very new. CRISPR. Do you know CRISPR? CRISPR is the one thing in this time is very popular. You can change the target of specific section of DNA into the, if you want to change the DNA, you can use the Cas9 nucleus and guide it and delete it and use the genes that you want, put it in and become the gene that you want. You will think this because the test with the gene therapy with the cystic fibrosis is successful with the mouse because of CRISPR is successful with the mouse. Okay, hold a great deal for mice as a possible donor. We can use some genes for human into the pig and you can get visit mosquito. They use CRISPR to mate with the male mosquito. You know, mosquito, they can make dengue viruses, something like that, many diseases. And scientists want to control the mosquito. They give it to the male mosquito to be, it cannot spread, something like that. And the disease, the dengue disease increased. And real, you can see now it launched in the market. This is a salmon. GM salmon, 24 inches. This is the farm salmon, it's just 13 inches. Yeah. This is Chinook salmon. And this is in nature. You can just, this is the mushroom. Normally mushroom is very dark, and this is becomes very white because there's inserted GMO, the protein oxidase, and reducing brown mushroom 30% and longer shelf life. Yeah, very clean. And this is tomatoes. Cold spring harbor laboratory use CRISPR to make SPG5 genes inactive and reduce protein anti-protein, and grooming right into meat faster. You can make it fresh. Instead of creating an offspring by chance, we can create an offspring by choice. Other questions are being asked. Do we have the right to alter the genome of other generations? Would the editing of certain diseases or disability lead to stigmatization of people who are living with those diseases or disability? Who get to decide what are considered diseases or disabilities that should be edited? Okay, now germline genetic modification is illegal in many European countries and in Canada, and federal funding the United States cannot be used for such work. In January 2017, researchers in UK, Sweden, and China have gotten approval to perform genome editing in human embryos for research purposes only. This time, this is a video. This is the trend of robotic ethics. You can see that. This is the dog like shape of the robot of Boston Dynamics. This is one company. They use this to transfer the document. It's like a dog. They kick it. Cool. Okay, they test it by kicking this dog. And cool. Stop it. After this video posted, Twitter, they talk a lot about this. Now, people always use the robotics in the human-like shape, in his face, like I'm handsome, and we have the dog with a handsome dog, and this is a dog, I love dog, something like that, to make it. Sometimes people, they have the group to think about what's the next generation of AI, the next generation of the robot should be. Sometimes the Twitters posted that if this dog launched, there will be aggressive people to keep the dog, the real dog, not the robot dog. It affects everyone. This is the next issue. This is the ethical landscape of the motif. We have to think about that. Very hard. So, in ethical engineering university, we have three boards, animals, human, and biosafety. Yeah. This is the website of Budapest University, which is ethic board. We also have this one. We have hotline. This is the group of IRB. This is the Institute Review Board Protection of Human Subject in Research. Yeah. We also have the secretary here, Dr. Lin Chai, here in this room. Okay. This is the animal care. Male safety, Dr. Marcus is here in this institution male safety committee. So we have to make sure that the research that performed in Gurabaya University, you know, be sued by other people, you know. So we have to take care of the animal that's in our university and reviews. And if I have time to talk, I would like to, I'm happy to be invited to talk to every person. I would like to talk about the ethic in human, animals, anything. This is I was in a magazine in Philippines. I was there. So, thank you. If you have any questions, please, welcome.